Now, this is a statement that I wrote myself last year, actually, when I was in Indonesia. I wrote this, and basically, I was very critical about the DSGE. Okay, Jana and Fauzi, did you distribute this paper to the students?
We haven't distributed the paper, but if you want, we can distribute after the class.
Actually, all those reading materials that I put, I think there are 7 of them. You better distribute all of them.
Okay, sir. Okay. Not
this is in, on top of the textbook, on top of the Oliver Blanchard textbook, okay? So I strongly recommend you to read that, especially if you're interested with the debt macroeconomics. I mean, models that are debt, and one of the models is really the DSGE. So this is a statement that I made about the DSGE. Okay. So DSGE model excludes everything relevant to the pursuit of financial stability. So if you use DSGE for policy making, then there is a risk of financial crisis, in which that risk cannot be detected by that model. That's basically what I meant by that statement. Now, if you use DSGE model for exercise, you know, for research, for even for exam in a class, that's fine. But what I meant is, if you use that model to make a policy, that's a dangerous one. And these are the list of the downside of the DSGE. I don't want to go into the detail, but just to give you a flavor. Remember, we are all going to discuss this during the semester. So today, I'm only introducing it. Okay. And this is the statement made by Oliver Blanchard in 2017, and 3 years ago. He said that the models, what he meant is macro models, the model should capture what we believe are the macro essential characteristics of the behaviors of economic agents, that is firms and people, not to try to capture all the relevant dynamics. So the key that he said is, when you talk about models, that models have to reflect the behavior of the agent, the behavior of people. Unfortunately, as I said earlier, economists are really bad in terms of predicting the behavior. We have to learn from sociologists, we have to learn from the psychologists, and so forth. And then in 2017, again, Joe Stiglitz, the Nobel laureate, said the same thing about the DSGE. He said the DSGE model is not good theory, because good theory is based on how firms and households actually behave and markets actually work. And he gave a very specific example, and by the way, this example we are going to discuss in class. I'm going to use this very example. So the example that Joe Stiglitz was referring to is about credit. You know, essentially what happened is that, according to the debt macroeconomic models, bank credit is determined by the interest rate alone. So in other words, if interest rate goes up, credits will go down. If interest rate goes down, credit will go up. So if you are basing on that simplistic model, that means there should not be any crisis or any recession, because if there's any recession, it's quite easy. Central bank has just lowered the interest rate. But why there's always crisis in reality, even after the central bank lowered the interest rate? So the reason why is because, in reality, bank decided to lend or not to lend, or decided to give or not to give credit, it's not just due to interest rate, but in this case due to the liquidity, whether the bank has enough liquidity or not. How do you check whether the bank has liquidity or not? Look at the balance sheet of the bank. Okay. That's what Joe Stiglitz was referring to. So credit is due not to interest rate alone, but also to the what they call credit rationing. But essentially, credit rationing is something related to the decision made by the bank whether or not to lend credit. And that is something to do with the availability of the liquidity. And unfortunately, the DSG model, again, this is an example of a debt model. The DSG model still assuming that credit of the bank is a function of interest rate alone. Okay. So that is an example that I don't want this class, you know, to adopt, because it's no longer alive, that model. This is just continuation of the criticism of the SGE, the debt model, okay? In fact, in Oxford, University of Oxford in UK, there's a project now, okay? It's called the Rebuilding Macroeconomic Theory Project. It's a big project involving economists from all over the world. I was involved in that project too. And basically, this project asks all the macroeconomists around the world. And the question is very simple. Is the benchmark DSG model fit for purpose? For the purpose, the purpose is to find the good macroeconomic models. Good meaning a model that can explain the effect like 2008 global crisis. Okay, that is what is considered good model. And when they do this survey to all macroeconomists around the world, the answer is resounding no. So a macroeconomist admitted that the SGE should not be fitting with the reality. Okay. From macroeconomic perspective, understanding the deep mechanism underlying financial friction is important because the role of finance goes beyond just providing financial intermediation. It could affect agent expectation and behavior, hence aggregate spending and capital flows. So, let me repeat, in the basic workhorse macro model, the role of financial sector is very limited. It's only helping you to understand how much you allocate your asset to currency and how much to saving or bonds. That's it. That's the only role of financial sector in the workhorse macro models. The reality is far more complex because there are many, many instruments of financial sector. And because many instruments of financial sector, the effect on the behavior of economic agents are also different and numerous, plenty of them. Well, I mean, again, look at the story in Indonesia now about Jiwasraya, about Taspen, about Bumi Putra and so on. Those are a clear black and white example when you do not understand the role of financial sector and all the risks in the economy, then basically you're bound to have this kind of a crisis, okay? And why it was believed and studied in many governments and in many macroeconomic classes, because they are basing it on DSGE, which is the debt model.